The core will collapse. Its density gets, it gets more and more tightly packed. Its density increases dramatically. And it keeps going. It doesn't go forever, though. Because when the density reaches about 2 to 3 times 10 to the 14 grams per cc, 200 to 300 trillion times the density of water, all of a sudden the rules change. Before, it was being governed to a first approximation by an ideal gas law. Actually, it's a little bit degenerate, but it's mostly the ideal gas law. When you reach a density of 2 to 3 times 10 to the 14 grams per cc, the star's core now has the density of an atomic nucleus. And now, the strong nuclear force takes over. Normally, the strong nuclear force, which is what binds nuclei, binds protons and neutrons into a nucleus, only occurs over the teeny, teeny, tiny space of an atomic nucleus. But now, the collapse of the core is one big atomic nucleus, in effect. The radius is now 10 kilometers. The strong nuclear force comes into play. So when we started a tenth of a second ago, we were 3,000 kilometers across at 10 billion times the density of water. And just a little over a tenth of a second later, we're 10 kilometers across. We've gone from the size of the Earth to the size of Columbus in a tenth of a second. The surface of that collapsing core is moving at one-tenth the speed of light. The strong nuclear force comes into play. The strong nuclear force is a very strong property. It's called the inner core force. It's repulsive, not attractive. And so the thing is basically slamming down at a tenth the speed of light, and all of a sudden the rules change. The equation of state now suddenly becomes instantly repulsive. And the collapse has to go from a tenth the speed of light to zero. Well, it's not going to stop on a dime. It's going to collapse, and it's going to overshoot. Spring is caught. What happens when you let it loose? It bounces back. So the core is going from zero to a tenth the speed of light and then zero again. It overshoots, the strong nuclear force makes a spring, and the core bounces. The core infalling envelope has also had the rug pulled out from underneath. The core literally falls out from underneath the inside of the envelope. And whoa, where'd my core go? What's it going to do? There's nothing to stop it. The outer envelope begins free falling, chasing the core as it begins to collapse. So we have infalling, free-falling envelope material, and we have the core collapsing, and it's speeding up and accelerating, and suddenly the core stops and bounces back and smacks right into the gas. What happens when the infalling envelope gas hits that core at a tenth the speed of light? Well, we have to go back to this idea of free-fall. Okay, the way free-fall works is nothing impedes the fall of an object, the fall of a parcel of gas. But free fall has a rule. You start with the gravitational energy you began with, and you turn that into kinetic energy as you fall. When you bounce, you turn the direction of motion around, but you don't get any more energy. In fact, you lose energy. So if I take this tennis ball, and I drop it from this height, about my nose height, it loses some energy. Where did some of that energy go? Anybody got a guess where the energy went? Give you a hint. Plop. Made sound waves. Lost some of its energy. Where'd the rest of it go? Someone carpeted the floor. Okay, so a little bit of deformation energy. So I free fall. I can only come back a little bit. But I've also got the core falling. And the core springs back. And when the infalling gas hits the inner core, the core imparts energy to the infalling gas, and it robs some of that energy from the core. So if I drop the basketball, an NCAA regulation basketball at the proper inflation, not the Patriots here, they go down, and I bounce back. What if they come down and catch the bounce? You all set there? You rob energy from the bouncing core, and you impart it to the envelope. So the outflowing, no, you can't keep that one. So just one more time, just so you can see that. You basically, now this is not exactly the physics that's going on. It's a lot more complicated, as you might imagine. But basically, you take energy from the bounce of the core and you smash it into the envelope. And you blast the envelope off. That core bounce is what makes the kaboom. That's going to happen to the next star.